Hello and welcome to the Arpa International Film Festival Q&A. Right now, we will be talking to one of the nominees of Best Short Animation Award. And this film is 10,000 Ugly Inkblots. Right now, we will be speaking to the producer of the film. Please introduce yourself, where are you from, and introduce your film, which will be screening for the Arpa International Film Festival.
大家好,我是来自中国。 吉林省吉林动画学院动画艺术学院的院长是水墨动画短片《万点恶魔》的制片兼动画监督。
Okay, so hello everyone. My name is Luo Jianglin. I'm come from the Jilin province, China, from the Jilin Animation Institute. I'm in charge of the producer of the 1,000 Ugly Inkblots, this film.
All right. So if I may ask, with a film like this, with a film that is so intricate and seems very sensitive, where does the story come from? Where does the inspiration come from for the story of this film?
由我们学校的这个教授和20多名这个师生共同进行创意和创作的这个水墨动画短片。那么德米特里先教授呢，在吉林动画学院呢已经工作了10年了。 在中国深深爱上了中国的文化和绘画艺术，以及电影，接触了明末清初著名画家八大山人朱达的作品，就萌生了拍摄这部利用独特创作视角浓郁的中国水墨绘画，并结合现代的动画语言，讲述这个朱达和石涛两位。 久为谋面的中国画的大师志同道合的这样的一个故事的动画电影，以此呢献给中国伟大的这个艺术家八大山人朱达和石涛，致敬他们的艺术人生。
Okay, so this film's director is the Dimitri Geller. He is the guesting professor of Jilin Animation Institute. So he's come from the Russia, and a Russia director was cooperated with our institute for over 10 years. So during these 10 years, he is loved with the Chinese culture and the Chinese painting and the Chinese film. So he wants to produce a Chinese characters film to represent his feeling. So this film is come from a Chinese Qing dynasty, very famous painter called Zhu Da. So he is the very famous 8th painter in that period. So he wants to produce this film use the ink technology with the combination with the animation to talk about Zhu Da, the friendship with the Zhu Da and also the Shi Tao, the friendship between their two very famous painter in Qing dynasty.
Okay. That is fantastic. Seems that inspiration comes from every angles, whether it be history or art or everything. Now, of course, with inspiration coming in from all angles, I assume that challenges also came in. And what sort of challenges did you face when making such a film?
因为用中国画的这种水墨画的方式来进行这个创作，会有大量的这样动画的素材，那么这素材的话呢，需要花费了前后5个月的时间来进行制作，同时呢，这个因为水墨风格呢，我们对动画的这个语言的一个表达，动画的节奏和镜头剪辑，在这方面下了很大的功夫。
Okay, so this most difficult of this film, the challenging is the poster. post-production part, especially the editing part, because it is ink style, in Chinese style. So we are drawing a lot of elements, a lot of things inside. So we need to choose what kind of part can use to in the animation. So the animation express, animation rhythm, and also the shoot is very difficult to choose. So this part we use 5 months to do this part.
With it as well, what do you feel that your film speaks about? When someone were to watch your film, what do you think it says about the world that we live in currently?
我们这个水墨动画短片呢，万点恶魔呢，是这个一部纯粹应用中国画技法，并且结合了这种新技术创作的8K级别的这个超高清水墨动画短片电影。那么我们整个这个团队在作品试验创作的过程中呢，总是这个在考虑我们怎么。去理解这些作品，能静静思考这些作品我们追寻的这个意义，所以呢，这个在整个创作的过程中呢，我们研究解决了一系列的这个关键的技术难题，形成了这种独特的这种技法和制作的这种工艺，所以创作了完成了这部具有中国文化民族艺术特色和时代精神的动画电影。
Okay. So this is the Chinese style, Chinese ink style, a short animated film with the 8K level of this film. This film is very difficult because it is a Chinese ancient traditional ink style. So it's difficult, we conquered the technology with the ink style combined with the animation to do this film. So we want to release, let the world people to know the Chinese culture, the our nation, the art of our nation, let the world people to understand the China and the Chinese culture.
Well, that's very interesting because I wish to ask a bit more in detail about the art style that was chosen for this. How exactly do you integrate such a technique into animation? Of course, the process must have been very difficult, I assume.
关于这个影片吧，是这个我们这个德米克里教授和团队呢，因为在中国这个生活。这个已经合作了快十年了对中国的这个绘画的艺术非常喜爱那么也这个非常这个对八大山人的这个作品呢也感觉到非常的震撼所以是想创作寻找这么一部这个以中国的这种水墨绘画风格为特色的像动画电影，那么就这个动画的这电影的艺术呢，首先是它的来源，就在适合这种题材的这样的土壤来进行创作，所以呢，这个电影的话呢，因为它是一个中国的这个清代的艺术家，是中国的这种中国画的这种水墨的艺术风格样式。所以呢，这部电影呢就探索在中国的这种文化意境下，和水墨画艺术的这种来源，来寻找这种作品的这种创作的灵感和实际的这种创作的土壤。
Okay. So, because the director, Dimitri Geller, we have cooperated with over 10 years, and he is very like the Chinese culture. So at the very first beginning, so we want to discuss about use the animation skill to reinvent the Chinese culture. So from the discussion, so finally we want to choose the ink style to because the Chinese Qing Dynasty is a very famous painter, so he loved very much. So we use the ink. So what they, what the very Chinese painter use the ink. So he want to use the ink into the animation, like to reveal, to want everyone to see what the Chinese culture in the animation. So this is the very first beginning what we thought. And later we combine the ink into the animation skills. Finally, we finished this work.
Well, watching the animation, it also reminded me that the music within the film is very specific to very certain parts of that film. What was it that also inspired the music to be presented in such a way? With like, let's say, with as soon as one line is drawn, then the violin comes in, and that's how, as if the story is driven forward.
因为这部影片的话呢，就是作为中国的这个传统的艺术的样式，这个中国画的话呢，大家都知道是历史比较悠久，一直的话它都是一个这种传统的这样的艺术。在传承，那么在当代这部动画电影呢，是把这个传统和当代的这种生活做了有机的这样的一个融合所以在传统里面的话呢，和两个这个时空的关系，一个是传统的。这样的一个时空，一个是现代的我们生活里面的时空所以你们可以看到这些山川桥梁、道路交通汽车和这种古老的这种文化和现代的这种生活这样的一种交融，所以在音乐的形式上的话呢，也同样是选用的传统的音乐和现代的这种小提琴这样的一些。这些音乐进行这种柔和来传达这种传统和现代这种交融这样的一个艺术的一个思想的一种表达。
Yes, you can see from this film, although it is a Chinese traditional style, but in this film you can see the very traditional things. Also, you can see the modern things, such as the road and the cars. So we want to combine the traditional things with the right now the Asian, the new things together. So it is also in the music. The music, we use some traditional elements and also some modern elements, just like the violin and other things to combine with this elements together. So the films, but not only the films, but also the music can combine with the traditional and the modern together.
Well, that is fantastic to hear. Now, if you don't mind me asking something of you maybe, what is it like to be a producer in an animation institute in China? If you could take us through your day, because a lot of people who will be watching this Q&A may not be too familiar as to what it is that producers, especially animation producers all the way across the seas, may experience throughout a regular day for them.
因为这个我们这个电影啊，是在这个吉林动画学院，由这个吉林动画学院的市长和校长郑立国先生呢亲自指导。那么我们这个学校呢，吉林动画学院呢，在中国的话呢，也是的唯一的这个学研厂一体化和开放式国际化以及创意产品高科技化这样的一个办学的这个特色这个来指导我们的这个创作的这个实践。所以呢，我们的整个这个影片的话呢，我们有自己的校园产业公司这个进行动画电影的创作和生产那么我们的学生的话呢，学习的阶段也就是和紧密的和 和动画电影的这种创作进行实践和创作，从一年级到四年级就进行这种试验动画的一些这样创作和整个动画的这种电影的市场紧密的进行结合所以呢，在这个我们的整个动画的电影的制片里面呢，我们是充分的吸收了这些动画电影的生产的这样的一个制片，用动画电影生产的制片和这个动画研究这样的话呢进行相结合所以呢，从学到研究，教学到研究到产业三位体的融合，对这种动画电影的话呢进行制片，所以这创作的时间也能够保障这个创作的高效同时呢也具有这种实验性。
Okay, so we just to introduce about the Jilin Animation Institute. It is in China. It is the biggest animation institute in China. And we have the president is Mr. Zheng Liguo. And we have the three characteristics of this our school. The openness, international orientation, the integration of education, research, industry, and also technology of creative production. So we use the three characteristics to training the students. Our students was not only in the school, was not only the study, but also they can come into our company to do the real project. So it will let our students get the not only the education part, but also the practice part, the training part. So this is what our studio do. Each year we will create many studios. These studios with the teachers and the students together to do short animated film. Not only the production part, but also the research part combined together to use our company and also our institutes, the results of these things. So as the producer, he's not only to in charge of the produce this film, but also to in charge of the teach students how to do the research together to finish this film. So he's in charge of the production this film, and also he think the time and the efficiency and also the research, also the education part. So we can combine this together.
对，就是以工业的流程和这个艺术的实验进行这个制片的这样的一个融合。
So as the producer, he is combine the work production part with the art and the practice together.
That is amazing. That is this is the first time I hear of a university being so letting their students be so hands-on with the projects, even the professional projects. A lot of the times that's usually not too integrated in there. So it is such an honor to be a student at the institute that you represent. And with this, of course, is there any upcoming films that you could tell us about? Something that we might be excited for next year?
我们现在已经创作了这个青蛙王国这块的话呢，已经今年的话呢是准备公映。现在正在创作的话呢，还有这个电脑都市传奇，这个卖火柴的小女孩，以及这个具有中国传统特色的这个以中国的这个山海经为题材的这个中国传统动画电影上海奇缘这块的话呢，现在也在创作过程中可能在这一年的话呢，陆陆续续都会进入这个国内外的这个电影的市场进行供应。
Our JI not only to produce the short animated film, we also can produce the feature film, 90 minutes animated feature film. We have already produced two feature film has already released in China, also abroad, called Frog Kingdom. Frog Kingdom 1 and 2 has already released. And Frog Kingdom 3 and 4 is just a producing part. And Frog Kingdom 3 will release this year in China and also abroad. Besides this part, we also have produced many other films, just like the Urban Computer and also a classic Chinese Asian story called The Battle of Mountain and the Sea. This film will just be in producing, maybe will release in next few years.
Well, that is fantastic to hear. I'm genuinely excited to actually see these films now, and I can't wait to actually see more films come out of this fantastic institute that looks like it. In any case, thank you so much for joining me. This was a very enlightening interview, actually. It was a very nice conversation. Thank you so much. And that's about it on my part.
好，非常感谢组委会对我们的这个电影的这个喜爱，也希望组委会能够一如既往的这个关注我们的这个电影和我们创作，希望以后的话我们能够建立更加紧密的这样的联系和合作，这个有更好的这个作品的话呢，能呈现到这个世界的关注，感谢。
Thank you very much. We thank the organizing committee likes our films and also your support to our films. We think in the future we will have many good films to do your Arpa International Festival, and we hope we can get a good cooperation together.
Of course, again, thank you so much. It is our complete pleasure and it is our complete honor. Thank you so much for joining me today.
非常感谢今天的采访，谢谢。
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.